I see all the time, and I wanted the same myself, is that all of these young people, when you ask them what they want to do with their life, they say, I want to become a YouTuber or just someone on social media. They want to do what they love, and they see that YouTube is a path to doing that. And although this may be exaggerated as a child, people feel the natural pull to do what they enjoy with their life. And there is and will become a way for the majority of the population to do this. That's what evolution is all about, is us solving the problems that make life bad for us. So eventually we're going to get to the point where we can do whatever the fuck we want because we've solved all the problems and built the technological solutions in order for us to do that. We're in the middle of this entire transition. And so I'm not saying that everyone's going to become a YouTuber, but I'm going to be able to say, I'm saying that people are going to be able to work in this creator economy, whether they are the sole huge face of the world creator or not, or they're working for a creator, more free time on their hands, just freelancing for them and being able to create the autonomy in their life that they want. And so the creator economy is composed of brands or city states in the sovereign individual's prediction. And then there's creators, which are the individual estates that maintain their own sovereignty. And so if you want to play a role in this next phase of evolution, the value creator is the answer for you. And so first, we need to talk about the importance of education, because the education system is just wrecked. Education is the first step in value creation. How are you going to create something valuable if you don't have the education on how to do so, or you don't have the skills, or you don't have anything? You don't have anything worth putting into, packaging up, and distributing to someone else that is valuable to them. So yes, in order to join in on this new economy, you're going to have to do something with your life. Shocker. But the conventional education won't cut it, because the current school system is just that. It's a system. A system has an end goal or desired outcome. It has tenets or variables or a path for people to do that and a starting point. So the societal system is go to school, get a job, right? That's the desired outcome. So what is school pushing you towards? It's training you into a job, because the school system is intimately tied with government, politics, and the economy, the old economy. And so you aren't going to find any of the education in there that threatens that system, because systems survive just like humans do, or how we survive the concept of ourselves. A system is a form within reality that will survive. If it breaks down, then the people that compose that system are going to fight to keep it together. And so if you want to make it in this new economy, then you're going to have to educate yourself from the people that created that economy or created this new system, even though it's a much more holistic system. So that means courses, coaching, and content from the brands and creators that created the jobs to begin with. Like, what blows my mind is some people don't trust people that don't have a degree when it comes to working for them or doing something in the creator economy, so to say. But it's like the school system, they're not creators. They don't know what it takes to actually build a business in this new economy. And so they don't have the right to teach you that, even if there's a course or curriculum around it. They haven't done it. So new jobs are being created left and right. And you know you're on the right track if a boomer tells you to get a real job. Because every great idea started as blasphemy until it became normal. So this area is still developing, but it's growing day after day. If you want to just prove it to yourself, go and look up a statistic on the projections of online education, or just the projection of the creator economy. It's absolutely fucking insane. Lifelong self-education will be a requirement to continue adapting to the digital landscape and being able to survive within this new economy. You're going to have to educate yourself on the skills required to make money. That's what I'm saying. Education shapes the future because it shapes human behavior. Education expands your perspective and allows you to spot opportunities in unknown territory. The new education system is being built online before your eyes. Set a goal. Find creators you resonate with, drown yourself in the information they provide, watch new opportunities, register in your awareness, act on them like your life depends on it. So there was a previous value creator video about 8 to 9 months ago that I made that did really well. It resonated with a lot of people. And so now I'm back here to recreate this video because I have more things that I can share with you, and there's going to be some repetition. But so it isn't too repetitive, in short, value creators are those that earn with their mind, not their time, so they can stay as a one-person business without limiting their income. One man's labor cannot scale, but their creative ability can. They research their obsessions and distill their learnings with writing, video, and other internet content. They get paid for aggregated knowledge and experience in the form of digital products or physical products if you want, but everyone should have some form of digital product. They have a heavy focus on educating their audience instead of posting memes, starting drama, or other things like that. And now I'm not saying you can't post memes or shitpost or whatever. You're supposed to entertain. You're supposed to be yourself. But I'm just saying you need different pillars of your brand. You can't just become a shitpost account and expect to become someone that's valuable and gets paid. You need to actually help people get results in their life, and that comes through education. And so the value creator is the type of one-person business that I teach. If you haven't already watched the one-person business model video, there's also the one-person business model 2.0 or the one-person business model series. I've talked about this a lot. And so in this value creator business model, it's about creating social media content and building distribution beneath your name as a person, and then building an education product or service that your past self could have used, like a course, coaching, or tutor offer, or even just a tool. Like if I was struggling with productivity in the past and now I'm very productive, I can create a planner for myself. I'm actually in the process of creating the Power Planner 2.0 to include with the Art of Focus book launch in the Keepsake Edition. And then, however much money you want to make, $100,000 a year to $3 million, $5 million a year, with time, with a lot of time, you can build whatever else you're going to do. So I'm not saying the company of your dreams or some billion-dollar company. I'm saying build a bridge and start making some form of good money first so that you can invest into that thing that's way higher than your current level. And then you use your personal brand or your value creation to actually fuel that. You have so much more leverage and you can do whatever you want. I see so many millionaires, I don't know about billionaires, I wanted to say that, but I know so many millionaires that built businesses, and I just saw one the other day, saw Heal Bloom, he's a good friend of mine, he posted and he's like, personal brands are the ultimate business hack or something. And he talked about how he's built multiple businesses before, and now when he builds a business, he already knows it's going to be successful because he has so many people that are already going to be customers. Because you have an audience, you know what they want, you create something for them that is valuable to their lives. It's not like you're just milking your audience for money by scamming them. You're giving them something valuable. You're creating something for them that they actually want to pay for, or else they wouldn't pay for it. The people that have such a bad psychological relationship with money always get this shit twisted. And so with this, why I like the education model the best is because you just tap into your own individual experience and you help people live better lives with the products that you create. And you actively create an education system online that new people can join, and they can choose the creators that they want to learn and learn best from, rather than all going through the same education system and turning into cogs in the machine. So now let's go over a few metaphors that I really like to help illustrate what a value creator actually is, or even just what a creative is. And so creators, in my eyes, are just DJs with ideas. So DJs play music sets. They mix together synths and sounds, and they remix certain things. In essence, they do a bunch of different things, and they turn it into a new thing. Technology has evolved to allow the DJs, specifically electronic music, and other people that use it, all of them use it, but they can create whatever they want because they're able to manipulate the sounds and piece things together so seamlessly, where just physical instruments wouldn't have been able to do that in the past. And so this sprung up all of these new genres and different things. Like, you look at EDM genres, electronic dance music, this is why I love it so much, it's just because everyone's creating new genres left and right. I understand the value of like classical music and how good it can be. I think it's silly to deny the creativity and evolution of this electronic music industry, and how that you can note that pattern in every other industry, and you can get in on the one that you want. So in the creator economy, with people growing this education, they're talking about new topics in education and creating this tree of content for people to explore. We're documenting the collective consciousness online. So with software and skill, DJs can blend together sounds into songs. With software and skill, creators can blend together ideas into content. They collect ideas of their own, others, and remixes of their favorites, then they weave them together with the evergreen skills, writing, speaking, marketing, and sales. With time, they attract an audience that invests their attention in those ideas. With that attention, they can benefit humanity and make an income doing what they enjoy. So one mistake that creators make here is that people want to hear the same sound from their favorite artists over and over again. So I like heavy dubstep. So Excision is someone, if you like Excision, you know what I'm talking about. Or just any heavy bass. I like a lot of the lower. Lesser known people as well. You've experienced this, where if one of those artists would change their sound, like you like the artist because you like their sound, it just hits different for you. And if Excision were to go and play, like, let's say drum and bass, it may be good, but if he were to switch over to that exclusively, or if he were to switch completely over to country music, then he would lose 90% of his audience. It's like you have a creative boundary to operate within based on who you are. And so the same thing goes with creators, is that people are so afraid about repeating themselves when repetition and conditioning is what actually changes people's lives. There's a reason I create so many one-person business videos, is because it's such a powerful concept. And from one-person business model video alone from last year wasn't the best that I could articulate it, and I didn't cover every single aspect of it, then who the fuck does that help? It helps no one. It's just like blue-balling people into, oh, here's a potential for a one-person business model, go try it out. But no, I have to keep repeating and conditioning the message into your head in a positive way. Programming can be good or bad. You can be programmed into a life that you hate or programmed into a life that you want. And so your job as a creator is to find an angle that resonates with people and milk it for eternity with your creative ability. Because I'm weaving in philosophy, spirituality, metaphysics, self-improvement to all of my videos, and I find a way to incorporate business aspects as well, even if the video isn't only about business. And so the number one reason people fail as value creators is that they're just afraid to put themselves on the market because they don't think that they're unique. How many pairs of shoes do you have? How many books on the same topic do you read? How many artists in the same genre do you listen to? Write what you would want to read, sell a product you would want to buy, make the videos you would want to watch, put your variation of what people want on the market, because only then does your luck increase from 0 to 1%. There are so many dubstep artists. There are so many artists within a specific genre that are seeing success. So how do we start our journey as a value creator? And it is by becoming a mental blacksmith, because blacksmiths, in a video game at least, will mine for ore to fuel their creations, and then they will smelt the ore and turn it into armor or weapons. Creators mine a crevice of reality that they are interested in, a specific topic, of course, while keeping the holistic aspect of things in mind. Like, if you're interested in health, then you're probably also interested in business, etc., etc. In short, you're studying certain things. You're just consuming information that you're interested in, and you're extracting lessons or ideas from it so that you can turn it into something new. And so with those ideas, we create armor and weapons to give to our audience. And armor is the perspective or worldview that helps people navigate reality in a better way. Like how a book can change your life because it brought awareness to a potential that you had no idea existed. And then weapons are the tools for battle, or the actionable advice, the how-to, teaching people how to actually do things and encouraging them to do it. And so how do we actually start doing this? First thing we do is we create a lens. So here's a graphic of your perception or your lens or your perspective. And this is, you consume information at the bottom, you see? So your vision, your goals, your problems, and you, it shapes how you perceive certain situations. And then from there, you extract certain parts of that information so that you can create. Because think about it, if you don't have a goal, like if you have a goal in your mind or a problem or your vision for the future in your mind, like the graphic showed, then if I have a problem of money in my life and it's actually top of mind, it's there, I'm perceiving situations through it because it's stressful, then I read a book. Doesn't matter what the fuck the book is. It can be on spirituality. It can be on academic writing. It can be on anything. You read it and it's going to, one of the words, one of the sentences, something is going to stick out to you that resonates with the problem pertaining to money. And then you can turn that and change how it's viewed or create something new for your audience who is trying to make money in a sense. I mean, you're reading through their problems as well, so you can help them solve the problems if you have that top of mind for them. And then you create something new because someone else is going to extract a completely different lesson. They're going to make a completely different highlight in the book depending on the goal, problem, or vision that they are working towards. So you need to build a project or have a goal or have a vision for your future. Why? Because leaders attract followers. This is your niche and brand. It is how you frame everything you read and write. This is how you create something valuable. Value helps people overcome their problems or achieve their goals. We are aiming to attract people with shared goals. Your brand is attracting people that has a shared goal or vision as you. That's how you're on the same page. So step number two after creating a lens is to pursue curiosity and collect material. Don't consume research. The best creators don't consume. They consume, but they do it from the lens of wanting to learn and apply, not just like entertain themselves. And this perception shift alone will turn you into an idea generation machine. You don't just scroll the internet and let everything pass you by and forget about it and laugh a bit about how funny that meme was. You read it with the lens to turn it into something of your own. You're looking for creative firepower. So you must fall back in love with learning outside of the traditional education system that made you hate it. Read books, listen to podcasts, read blog posts and newsletters, and immerse yourself in information that aligns with your goals. Have a notebook, app, or idea development system like 7 Days to Genius Ideas, free in the description, to keep your ideas safe. No, you won't remember them. This step is absolutely critical. I'm not exaggerating. do it. Note down the ideas that raise dopamine in your brain, the ones that rivet your attention to them, the ones that change your perspective and bring you clarity. Contemplate different angles of the ideas you jot down and how they apply to your vision goals and problems in your life. This is what you write about in your content. Because the thing is even if an idea, you're writing about ideas, you're distributing ideas, you're not writing about topics, you're helping people overcome problems in their life towards their goals. Doesn't matter if that has to do with money, health, whatever. If it helped you understand and brought you clarity, then share it with your audience. If it's something spiritual and you're so focused on building a business, but it helped you, then it's going to help someone else build a business. This is why I'm not huge on picking one niche and sticking with it and hammering it out. It's because you're missing out on so much more to life, and you're missing out on how you can actually serve your audience. Reality is not niche down. You are not niche down. Watch my video, Niche Down is Stupid Advice or Terrible Advice for Smart People. So if you want courses with exact steps and strategies, check out Tour Writer or Digital Economics. I talk about this all in there with practical steps. So step three is that you want to create armor and weapons. As we talked about, we're becoming mental blacksmiths, because the ideas you collect from your curiosity pursuit or your learning will start to shape your worldview and perspective, and thus your identity. That's going to shape who you are, because you're going to start holding that as who you are. Oh, I'm a writer, I'm a value creator, I'm this, I'm that. It's going to change how you act in the world. So for armor creation, give people ideas, motivation, and inspiration toward their goals. This shapes their perspective and identity. They can be happier in life and achieve their goals. Weapon creation is about giving actionable steps, solutions, and advice. Writing, speaking, marketing, sales, watch the $1 million skill stack video, are how you channel your ideas into impactful creations. If you don't understand psychology or mechanics or just marketing, in order to craft a message that is actually perceived as valuable to someone else, because marketing is perception, but value is perception. So that's what a value creator is, and now we need to talk about monetizing the creative ability of your mind. Because we are shifting away from shallow promises and good looks as a way of building an audience. It's less about, ooh, look at me, and more about, ooh, look at you, here's what you can do. And the health industry, the fitness industry, continues to grow unhealthy because people's income is dependent on their looks. I've heard this in many podcasts. I'm deep in the fitness industry in terms of like what I listen to and what I like doing in my free time. And what I've noticed is that people that aren't intelligent, I'm not saying they aren't intelligent, I'm saying that they don't have a way of educating their audience. They're banking on the algorithm, AdSense, and getting paid by the platform, or even their coaching programs. They're banking on their looks and less about their persuasive ability in order to make an income. And I've heard this many times, is that when people actually gain weight to get to a healthy body fat percentage where they feel better and they aren't shredded all the time, their income decreases by a lot. And so they have to get shredded again. They have to lose body fat and be unhealthy in the health industry in order to make money. And so the smart people that educate and write and create information products on this thing are the ones that actually make more money and have a sustainable way of making money in that health industry. And so that's just one example, because there's more than that, right? There's visuals and there's art and there's other things. If you don't back that with a philosophy or depth or education around those things, you're not necessarily setting yourself up for success. This was my problem when I was a digital artist, is that I just wanted to sell my little art things and I didn't provide any education. I didn't teach people how I did it. And so before we go any further, we need to handle two limiting beliefs here that many of you have. The first is that you can build an audience or readership. Every single person on social media follows 300 to 1,000 people, even creators. I follow that many people. That's more than enough to make a full-time income if you know what you're doing, because your audience is not just your audience. I've talked about this so many times before. Just start, because I can go over the math. I can talk about network effect. I can talk about you not needing to sell a digital product for $100, you can sell a service for $2,000 and you don't even need an audience to do that, but you do need to actually be showing that you know your shit on your profile, and you can grow if you want to. There's more than enough strategies to actually grow. The second thing is that the market is not saturated. It only seems saturated because you're following the 300 to 1,000 people that are all talking about the same things, and you're getting shared posts that those people resonate with as well. You have no fucking clue what's going on the complete other side of the internet. And if you were thrown into that area, you'd be lost. You'd have no idea what was going on. You'd hate it. You're in your own little social media bubble of comfort because you feel like it. If you went on Threads, the new Instagram app, the first day, you were seeing all this content that you just weren't used to. And you're like, what the fuck is this? Is this app good? I found some good people that I like. And then eventually it's now more tailored. And so if you pair this with my way of niching down, which is the most profitable niche is you video, then you're gold. So now we need to talk about simplifying complex topics as the greatest skill of the 21st century, because value creators are sense makers. Your job is to make sense of your life, the world, and bring clarity to the actions that others should take, the ones that follow your vision and want to make it a reality. This comes with time and action. You will not know if your creations are valuable if you never get eyes on them. If you're not writing content, this is another thing I saw on Threads, the Instagram app, because it sounds weird saying Threads because that's a thing on Twitter. I see people like, oh, it's my time to shine now that Threads is like new and beginning. It's like, yeah, you have a bit more opportunity, but you're still at ground zero in terms of your idea generation. If you would have written 10,000 tweets without any form of growth on Twitter, which wouldn't have happened, then you'd be in a much better spot and you would grow a lot faster on Threads. But no, you feel like you have to start from scratch and get those 10,000 iterations out of the way and make the same amount of progress that you would either way, whether or not you're starting on a new platform or not. You don't have the experience of creating shit because you must post. You need data. You need to refine your ideas over time and figure out which ones are going to do the best. The only way I was able to go from Twitter over to Instagram and actually grow on there is because I had 20,000 tweets and 100 of those being the best, and I can make 100 Instagram posts and all of them pop off. All of them give me the most followers possible because those are the ones that brought me the most followers on Twitter. You have to get under every 100 good posts, there's 1,000 bad posts. And if you don't put in those reps, you're fucked. If you don't get your content in front of people, you won't know if your ideas are valuable. If you get your content in front of people and it doesn't do well, then it wasn't valuable. You need to write better. If you don't work to get your products in front of people, you won't make money. If you get your products in front of people and no one buys, your product isn't perceived as valuable. You need to sell better. Do you understand? Just think critically about why you're not making progress. It's obvious. Because perceive is the key word here. Marketing and sales are perception. You need to write, speak, market, and sell to the identity that you are targeting, which is you. You need to write to yourself.
Downtime of your applications can mean big costs to your finances and
in a way that actually resonates with you. Because a valley girl won't resonate with a meathead bodybuilding advice. A soccer mom probably won't resonate with philosophical musings on business. Your language dictates who you attract. Okay, so where do we start? We start with writing. It clarifies your thoughts, it makes you more articulate, it can be repurposed into any other medium, speaking, video, or visuals. It is also a seamless, non-demanding, lever-moving task that you can schedule in the first block of each morning. So, we prioritize growth and content on writing platforms like the new Instagram Threads, Twitter, email newsletter, etc., and then you just repurpose those to anything. You want to create a real script or short script? Read one of your tweets. You want to create a YouTube video? Oh, you have newsletters and blogs in place. It's that simple. So, but we're going to start with a newsletter first and foremost, because depth is what separates you on a superficial market. No, you don't need email subscribers, because you can also upload it to a blog. If it helps, just think about it as writing blog posts that will grow in traction over time. Or you can use it as a way to build out your lead magnets or products in real time. And no, it doesn't matter if you give those sections of them away for free, because subscribers will come eventually, and you're building such a... It's so fucking powerful to actually create the depth. That was... If you go and look at my profiles anywhere, my brand took off when I started writing long form. And so if you just keep at it with long form, short form, and sending traffic to each, then eventually you do very well. Because that's what you do next, is you condense the complexity into tweets. With a newsletter, you're writing out everything that's on your mind relating to the topic. You're educating people. You're helping people understand. That is the most valuable. But now you need to tap into human psychology and create some form of short, heavy-hitting ideas that attract people that you can lead into that longer form, because people naturally read shorter form content, and you need to encourage them to see the value in what you have to offer in the long form. And so Twitter, in my eyes, was an underrated writing platform. It still is. I used to talk about it in like almost every video, but now I'm on Threads. I like Threads a lot, actually. It reminds me of Twitter in its infancy. And it's just really fun to be there. Like, if you're not on Threads yet, before it starts to develop more and you don't see the raw community that's there, don't miss out on it. It's just fun. And so Threads has a lot of potential. Why? Because you can post as much as you'd like to test your ideas before you post them on other platforms. It's writing based, meaning you don't have to be a 10 out of 10 model living in Thailand sipping coconuts on the beach. It is like a forum where you can find like-minded people much quicker in the replies of your favorite accounts. The retweet or repost button is a low friction share feature. That's how you gain followers. Other platforms are harder to grow on as a beginner. Replies are actually heavily favored on Threads, just reply, reply, reply. And you can just screenshot your tweets or threads to grow on other platforms. This is how I grew without spending hours on creating new content. And so the basics of growing on Twitter and Threads are simple. Post 1 to 3 times a day and start getting your failures out of the way. If you are under 1,000 followers, focus on networking with other people in the replies and DMs to leverage their audience. Have a clickable profile picture so people know that you are a creator. Use your big goal in life or the interests you talk about as your bio, what you're leading people towards and how will they get there through your unique interests. And write threads or long posts based on your story and personal experience. But make sure you have a network to share it so that it will go semi-viral. Start with beginner-level educational content. Make it actionable, because that's what everyone's doing when they start growing on a certain platform. People start posting whatever they want, and then they don't grow. But when you look at a YouTuber and you look back at their history, it's usually actual advice on the topic that they actually have expertise in while baking in their personality or other interests with it. So step number 2 after writing, just writing, is prioritize ideas and attention capture. Because attention is the currency of the 21st century, and ideas are how you capture attention. And so without getting too complex here, I'm just going to give you a few examples of how to capture attention. I talk about this in Digital Economics and To Our Writer, or you can just read a book like Influence by Robert Cialdini. So problems are the first thing. Every good story captures attention by starting with a problem that the reader is facing. It opens a curiosity loop and makes them want to find the solution. Problems are at the root of human behavior. Numbers, or specific numbers, are a pattern interrupt when you're scrolling on social media. Example is, I read 347 self-help books so you don't have to, is an example. Statistics, similar to numbers, statistics set the scene quite nicely. 97% of the population has seen a decline in focus. Here's how to fix yours. It's an example that could use a bit of work, but you see the power in it. So step number 3 is to treat yourself as your ideal reader. So when you're building an audience or you're just selling something, the common advice is to sell to an ideal customer or a customer avatar. So with the one person business that I teach, I say that you are the niche. So you're writing and selling to yourself. You are the customer avatar. So in Digital Economics, I have people take the Myers-Briggs personality test. Every time I recommend something, there's always like some expert in it. And I think it's cool, but there's like personality people where they're like crazy about the personality tests, and there's 10 times better tests you can take. It's like, we're just getting an idea here. We're helping understand ourselves a tiny bit more just so you can write better. You don't need to do this at all, because when you understand yourself, you can write to yourself. But now, what do you write? If you're going through a tough time, give yourself advice and write it online in your public journal. Give your past self advice on overcoming the problems you faced, but faster. Give your future self encouragement to achieve the goals you were trying to achieve. These are just a few of the many ways to actually start creating content. So step number 4 that I always talk about is to turn your personal projects into products. Because in anywhere that you're making progress in life, right? So if you are a health personal brand and you're making progress in health and you're documenting the journey and you're making progress, then you can, that's technically a project that you can package up and sell to someone else. If you've grown an audience or you've gotten better at writing or you've gotten better at marketing or whatever skill it is or interest that you're interested in, spirituality, whatever, this is how you start becoming an actual expert, is by selling something, getting feedback on it and making it better. Because in my eyes, yes, I don't think that scams or certain products should be on the market. But at the same time, you have to realize, like, how else is the industry going to evolve? Like, the bad actors or the people that are actually scamming people, yes, they need to be eradicated off the face of the earth. I completely agree with you. But bad products in general, yes, they need feedback. Yes, they need to be called out every now and then. But there's going to be bad products on the market just because of how hierarchies are formed. There's going to be good products by the people that stick it out and actually iterate, and there's going to be bad products by the people that, one, decide to take action, which is a great thing, but two, they don't actually decide to stick it out because they took the feedback too seriously. So what I'm saying here is that don't let people gatekeep you from actually putting something on the market that you can only then improve. You can't improve it before you put it on the market because you don't have data. So just teach people how to get the results they want. It's that fucking simple. Get better with time. And it helps to study others' products or services or just brands or content or whatever so that you have inspiration for your own and you actually understand how to structure it. So buy courses, look at content, actually be inside this economy, creator economy that you're trying to join. Because again, if you want a job, then go pay for an overpriced degree. If you want a life's work, then pay a few bucks here and there for a course, book, or whatever that allows you to do so. So that's it for the end of this video. Happy value creating, if you will. But courses, products, links in the description for all that stuff. The Art of Focus book is still about to launch. Its pre-order will be going out soon. Just stay tuned for that. We're just patiently waiting for things to be approved, for certain things to come in. But yeah, aside from that, like, subscribe. Thanks, dudes and dudettes. I got canceled there.